हरि ओम। गणेशाय नमः। ॐ श्री हिरण्यगर्भाय नमः। ॐ श्री महाविष्णवे नमः। ॐ श्री महादेवाय नमः। ॐ श्री महादुर्गायै नमः। ॐ श्री राम रामाय नमः। ॐ श्री सद्गुरवे नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहना भुनक्तु सह वीर्यंकरवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांतिः। ॐ गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं भवानीशंकरो वन्दे श्रद्धाविश्वासरूपिणो याभ्यां विना न पश्यन्ति सिद्धा स्वान्तस्तमीश्वरम् वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताय पतये नमः। बुद्धेर्बलं यशोधैर्यं निर्भयत्वमरोगता अजाड्यं वाक्पटुत्वं च हनुमत्स्मरणात् भवेत्। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशंकरं लोकशंकरं सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ नमः शिवाय। 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 नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव। हरि ओम। हरि ओम। सीइंग भगवान विश्वरूप अर्जुना डज अ ब्यूटिफुल स्तुति एंड ही प्रेज टू भगवान दैट प्लीज शो मी योर चतुर्भुज रूप एंड योर सौम्य रूप. सो इट्स द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल प्रेयर वी हैव सीन दैट इन द बिगिनिंग अर्जुना praises Bhagwan, talks about his swarupa, that whatever he does is proper, and everyone rejoices in Ishvara because he is the our own self and the very source of all happiness. Arjuna does namaskar to Bhagwan and asks for forgiveness for any inappropriate action from him, not knowing the mahima of Ishvara. And he requests Bhagwan to show him his that friendly form. Tadeva me darshaya deva rupam prasida devesha jagannivasa, and be pleased with me. I want to see your that Shankh Chakra Gada Padmadhari Rupa and your Saumya Rupa. So Bhagwan blesses Arjuna and tells him that what form you have seen is very rare, nobody has seen before you, and even with all the study of the Vedas and Dana and Tapas and all, it's not possible to see me in this form. So don't get agitated, and you can see my Saumya Rupa. So having said this, Sanjaya tells Dhritarashtra that having said this to Arjuna, Bhagwan then showed him his Saumya Vapu. So now Arjuna, seeing the beautiful form of Shri Krishna again, he speaks. Verse number 51 we will chant. Arjuna uvacha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava saumyam janardana idanim asmi samvrittah sacheta prakritim gatah. Arjuna vacha, Arjuna is saying that, hey Janardana, the one who blesses everyone, who is desired by all devotees, is that Janardana who dispels all our problems, removes all our obstacles from our life, gives us joy. He is Janardhan Bhagwan. So Arjuna addresses Bhagwan as Janardana. Ki drishtva idam manusham rupam. First Bhagwan showed Arjuna his Vishwarupa. He also showed Arjuna his Ugra Rupa. And thereafter, on request of Bhagwan, request of Arjuna, Bhagwan also showed him his Chaturbhuja Rupa with four arms. And then again Bhagwan came back into Manushya Rupa. So Arjuna says, ki drishtva idam manusham rupam, having seen you again in this human form, tava saumyam Janardana, this saumya rupa, very pleasant, very nice form. And Arjuna was used to seeing Bhagwan in this form, and he had this great love and affection for Bhagwan. So having seen this form again, Arjuna says that idanim asmi samvrittah, that now my mind has calmed down. I am feeling very, very calm. Sacheta prakritim gatah prasanna chittah, my chitta has become prasanna. and seeing you in this form. My mind has gained its balance and I am feeling very, very calm seeing you again in that human form. See, sometimes we are not ready to see Bhagwan's that Vishwarupa. We are not ready to comprehend the world in a more holistic way, though that is the fact, but our mind, our intellect, if it is not ready, we might not be able to bear with it. Might be very frightening, or might be very disturbing, or maybe very confusing also. So here Arjuna was very disturbed seeing Bhagwan's that Ugra Rupa, but now seeing Bhagwan in human form, Arjuna is feeling very calm and peaceful. Ki idanim asmi samvrittaha. He says that now, seeing you in this form, I am feeling better. Sacheta prakritim gataha. I have become, prasannata has come, and I have regained my balance. So here the meter has also changed again back to Anushtup Chandah. Previously it was in a different meter, the whole description of Bhagwan's Vishwarupa and also Arjuna's prayer in a different meter altogether. But now again the Chanda has come back to Anushtup Chanda. So now Bhagwan as Manushya Rupa, he speaks to Arjuna again. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Sudur Darshamidam Rupam Drishtavanasi Yanmama Deva Apyasya Rupasya Nityam Darshan Kangshinaha. Shri Bhagwan Vacha. Bhagwan, Sakshat, that Bhagwan, Ishvara, who is Brahma itself, that Brahma alone is manifested as that Krishna. So Shri Bhagavan Vacha, ki sudur darsham idam rupam drishtavan asi yan mama. Hey Arjuna, you have seen my rupa, which is sudur darsham, which is very, very difficult to see. It's not very easy. Sushtu dukhena darshanam asya iti sudur darshanam, sudur darsham. Very difficult to see, very difficult to comprehend. My this universal form is very difficult to see and comprehend by our own little intellect. What you have seen by my grid, drishtavan asi yan mama, what you have seen by my blessings, it is not very easy to see. But all the devatas and everyone desires to see this form. Deva api asya rupasya nityam darshana kangshinaha. Even the devatas want to see my universal form. They also want to see my universal form. See, like we are staying here on earth. Very beautiful planet. Blue, lots of water. Lots of greenery, most fascinating planet in the entire solar system, and we live here on Earth. But from Earth, however much we try, we are unable to see the entire Earth. We are unable to see the vastness of this Earth. Because our vision is very, very limited. But when a person takes off on some rocket and goes up in space, or even when we fly, or take a flight, we are able to see more, little more expanse of this earth. But that is also limited. But when a person takes off, goes out in space, and from there when he looks at earth below, it has got a different charm altogether. A blue, beautiful earth is seen. So to see the whole earth or a large portion of earth is a different experience altogether. Everyone doesn't get it. Similarly, to see the entire cosmos, entire universe, along with all the devatas and all the beings, is not easy, but very, very fascinating. So, Bhagavan says that even devatas, deva api asya rupasya nityam darshana kankshinaha, always they have this kanksha, this desire in their heart to see me in this universal form. But you have seen, and by my grace, by my blessings, you had the opportunity to see my universal form. Further, Bhagavan says, Naham vedairna tapasa nadanena na chejaya shakya evam vidho drashtum drishtavanasi mam yatha. Bhagavan says that na aham vedaihi. Bhagavan had mentioned this before also, that it is not possible to see me in this form just by study of the Vedas. Na aham vedaihi. See, the Vedas are anadi, ananta, paurusheya, the most fascinating expression of that supreme reality, absolutely miraculous and stunning, and the only praman to recognize our own self. Any knowledge, anything which is in tune with Vedas are proper. Anything which is not in tune with Vedas are totally trash. They are not worth anything. So our Puranas, our Dharma Granthas, our Itihas, all of them are in tune with the Vedas. Wherever there is any conflict, then Vedas are considered more pramanic. So even here in Bhagavad Gita, even Bhagavan himself, when he talks about that Supreme, he mentions the Vedas. He talks about the importance of Vedas. But just by merely by understanding the Vedas, or just by gaining theoretical knowledge of the Vedas, will not give us the experience of that Supreme. That's what Bhagavan says here, ke na aham vedaihi, just by merely studying the Vedas, Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samveda, Atharva vedaihi, I will not be seen in this form. Na tapasa, nor by just doing some tapas. Many times people feel that just doing some very hard austerities, we will be able to see, we will be able to gain some spiritual experience, we will have some vision. So many people, they torture their bodies and they do all sorts of hard austerities in order to have that some spiritual experience. But Bhagavan says this is not possible. Na tapasa, just by merely doing some senseless, irrational, tapas without proper guidance, without proper understanding, will not take us anywhere. Na dana, na, just by merely giving dana, we will get punya. But just by getting punya, there is no guarantee that we will have the darshan of Bhagwan. We will have the experience of Bhagwan. There is no guarantee. Dana and all is a very great sadhana which we have to do. It not only purifies our mind, but also takes us more towards gaining that supreme result, enlightenment. It helps. But merely by dana, we will not be able to experience Ishvara. Nacha ijaya. Bhagavan says, even by different yajnas and rituals, puja, or yajna, yajnena pujaya va, there is no guarantee that we will be able to experience God, experience Ishvara. He says, shakya na shakya evam vidho drashtum. It is not possible to see me in this way. Drashtavanasi mam yatha, as you have seen me. See, whatever sadhana we do, whatever ritual we do and all, the ultimate result we gain by Bhagwan's blessing only. He is the giver of the result of all our karmas, our upasana, our jnana, our dhyana. By Bhagwan's grace only, we gain it. See, even if you want to sleep, if Bhagwan's grace is not there, we won't be able to sleep. And without Bhagwan's grace, we will not be able to wake up also. Even the dreams which we have by Bhagwan's grace alone. And all that we achieve in this world, also by Bhagwan's grace. So just by our senseless effort, we will not be able to recognize and realize that Ishvara. So shakya evam vidho drashtum drashtavanasi mam yatha, as you have seen me. So what is the method? What is the way to have Bhagavad darshan? See, we may not see Bhagwan in the same way as Arjuna has seen, but we can realize Bhagwan and we can understand that the self in me is the self in all. So realization and experience of Ishvara is possible for all. But how? Not by merely by studying the Vedas, not by just theoretical knowledge, not by some senseless tapas or dana or yajna, but something else is required. Along with all this sadhana, something else is required. See, there is a story in the Puranas wherein Bhagwan, Shri Krishna was weighed in gold. One of his wife, he weighs Krishna in gold and gives that gold in dana. So she puts all the gold ornaments and everything on one side of that balance, and Bhagwan is sitting on the other side. But however much she puts wealth and gold and everything, still Bhagwan is very heavy. So everyone is worried what to do. All the wealth we put and still Bhagwan is heavy. Then one tulsi leaf is put. And as soon as the tulsi leaf is put, the whole balance balances very beautifully. is symbolic. That we offer so many things to Bhagwan in our puja, in yajna, and all those things. But if we offer with love, if we offer with devotion, then it reaches Bhagwan. If there is no devotion, it doesn't reach. That doesn't reach him. We have seen in the 9th chapter also, ki patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayaschati. Whatever is offered to me, patram pushpam phalam toyam, a leaf, a flower, a fruit, or even water, but bhaktya, with love, then I accept it. Then it comes to me. And when it comes to Bhagwan, it becomes one with Bhagwan. So whatever sadhana we do, whether we do dana, whether we do puja, whether we do yajna, whether we do tapas, whether we do the study of the scriptures, whatever it is, it all should be backed by bhakti, by love for God. If that is there, then everything becomes fulfilled. If that is not there, then everything is just a waste of time. And that is what Bhagwan now conveys very beautiful. In the next verse, he says, bhaktya tvananyaya shakyah अहमेवं विधोर्जुन ज्ञातुं द्रष्टुं च तत्वेन प्रवेष्टुं च परंतप. भगवान सेज दैट नॉट दैट इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू सी मी और एक्सपीरियंस मी, इट इज पॉसिबल थ्रू द वेदा, थ्रू तपस, थ्रू भक्ति, थ्रू पूजा एंड ऑल, इट्स ऑल पॉसिबल. बट वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड is your love, your bhakti. Bhaktya tu ananyaya shakyaha, with ananya bhakti, not ordinary bhakti. Ananya bhakti. What is ananya bhakti? Shankaracharya ji writes, ki ananyaya apratak bhutaya, bhagavatah anyatra pratak na kadachit. Single pointed devotion to Ishvara. That other than Ishvara, there is no other altar of devotion for me. That is ananya bhakti. Na kadachit api ya bhavati sato ananya bhakti hi sarvaihi api karanaihi vasudevat anyat na upalabhyate yaya sa ananya bhakti. With all our instrument, like our senses, our mind, our intellect, all of them are dedicated to Ishvara alone, to attain Ishvara. With full our personality, we have to surrender to that Ishvara and have the desire to attain Ishvara. Later on in the 18th chapter also Bhagavan will say that tameva sharanam gacha, that you surrender to that sarva bhavena bharata, you surrender to that Ishvara, to me. So bhaktya tu ananyaya, ananya bhakti. Ananya bhakti, single-pointed love, total 100% love for Ishvara. Everything else is secondary. Ishvara is the first. Every other love is with respect to love for Ishvara. That is ananya bhakti. Bhaktya tu ananyaya shakyaha. See, we have our attachment and attraction to so many things and beings and places in this world. People are attached to places. People are attached to other beings, things, and to Bhagwan also. That is not ananya. Ananya means Bhagwan se hi prem. Mere to giridhar gopal, dusaro na koi re. Like Mirabai says, that for me, only giridhar gopal is there, no other. Not that she doesn't interact with other people and all, but in her heart, she is totally dedicated only to Ishvara. Nobody else. Nothing can come in between. Neither people, nor things, nor beings. Nothing can come in between her and her or her Lord. That is Ananya Bhakti. So bhaktya tu ananya shakyah aham evam vidorjuna. He Arjuna, it is shakyah, it is possible to see me and experience me in this way through bhakti. So what is possible? Nyatum, drashtum, cha tatvena, praveshtum cha parantapa. Very beautiful. Bhagavan says, hey Parantapa, through bhakti you will be able to know me, nyatum. You can know me, drashtum, you can see me, tatvena, in my tatva, and praveshtuncha, and you can enter me also. What does it mean? Our Shankaracharya ji, he writes, कि हे अर्जुन ज्ञातुम, ज्ञातुम मीन्स शास्त्रतः, न केवलम ज्ञातुम, शास्त्रतः विद द हेल्प ऑफ द स्क्रिप्चर्स वी कैन नो भगवान इफ अवर स्टडी इज एकम्पनीड विथ लव. नॉट जस्ट मियर मियर इंटेलेक्चुअल व्हाट यू कॉल टाइम पास लाइक नो विद दैट सिंसियरिटी दैट लव. When we study with the guidance of our teacher, the Shastras, then we are able to understand. Because to understand, we require a lot of dedication, lot of stamina, intellectual stamina. We should have a lot of patience. Should not get tired and bored and give up, no. We have to keep on studying for a long time, contemplate, meditate, discuss, try to understand it. Because Bhagavad Tattva is very, very miraculous, very, very wonderful, and very, not very easy to comprehend, but most fascinating. And as you put forth effort to comprehend, then slowly and steadily the understanding happens. So that total dedication is required. That is our bhakti for gaining knowledge. See, bhakti is that our bhava which is generally should be present in our karma, in upasana, in jnana, in dhyana, everywhere. It is required. Bhakti is not a separate path as such. Bhakti is a attitude which we should have following the path of karma, upasana, jnana, dhyana. So jnatum shastrataha, we can know with the help of the scriptures. And na kevalam jnatum shastratah drashtuncha. Not only knowing Bhagwan, but drashtum. Drashtum means sakshat kartum. Directly we can experience. In our meditation, we can experience Bhagwan in his universal form. Means we can experience our own self, not different from Ishvara. We can gain that sarvatma bhav. Experiencing, gaining that sarvatma bhav itself is like having the darshan of sarvarupa bhagwan, vishvarupa bhagwan. That sarvatma bhav, the self in me is the self in all. So jnatum drashtum sakshatkartum, iska sakshatkar hum kar sakte bhagwan ka. Not only sakshatkar, but praveshtum. साक्षात्कार तत्वतः तत्वतः इन हिज एसेंस वी कैन रिकॉग्नाइज ईश्वर एंड प्रवेश टू मीन्स डायरेक्ट मर्जिंग विद ईश्वर गेनिंग मोक्ष मोक्षंच गंतुम परंतप ऑल दिस इज पॉसिबल इफ वी अकंपनी अवर साधना विथ इंटेंस भक्ति अनन्य भक्ति इफ दैट अनन्य भक्ति इज नॉट देयर देन ऑल अवर साधना बिकम्स फ्रूटलेस कर्मयोग विदाउट भक्ति इज नॉट कर्मयोग ज्ञान विदाउट भक्ति इज नॉट ज्ञान ध्यान विदाउट भक्ति इज नॉट ध्यान भक्ति इज टोटल डेडिकेशन टोटल लव जैसे हम अपने आप से प्यार करते हैं लाइक दैट वी लव ईश्वर टोटली दैट इज भक्ति सो ज्ञातुम द्रष्टुम च तत्वेन प्रवेष्टुम च परंतप हे परंतप यू विल बी एबल टू नॉट ओनली नो मी बट यू कैन सी मी एंड यू कैन बी मी बी वन विथ मी यू कैन नो मी यू कैन सी मी एंड यू कैन बी वन विथ मी इफ यू डू योर साधना विद भक्ति अनन्य भक्ति सी मोर अबाउट दिस भक्ति भगवान विल टॉक नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर 12th चैप्टर इज मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल चैप्टर वेयर भगवान टॉक्स अबाउट भक्ति एंड ही ऑल्सो टेल्स अबाउट द लक्षणास ऑफ भक्त सो यर भगवान इज जस्ट हिंटिंग एट वॉट ही विल एलोबरेटली टॉक इन द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर टेल्स अबाउट भक्ति एज आई सेड भक्ति इज नॉट अ डिफरेंट पाथ देर आर ओनली टू पाथ्स द पाथ ऑफ कर्म एंड पाथ ऑफ ज्ञान लोकेस्मिन् द्विविधा निष्ठा पुरा प्रोक्ता मयानग ज्ञान योगेन सांख्यानां कर्म योगेन योगिनां वी हैव सीन बिफोर ऑल्सो द पाथ ऑफ प्रवृत्ति एंड पाथ ऑफ निवृत्ति द पाथ ऑफ एक्शन एंड द पाथ ऑफ मेडिटेशन बट इन बोथ दिस पाथ्स वी नीड द सपोर्ट ऑफ भक्ति लव इंटेंस लव सो आफ्टर टेलिंग दिस नाउ इन द लास्ट वर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर भगवान गिव्स द वेरी एसेंस ऑफ द टीचिंग ऑफ भगवद्गीता और शंकराचार्य जी राइट्स कि अधुना सर्वस्य गीताशास्त्रस्य सारभूतः अर्थः निःश्रेयसार्थः अनुष्ठेयत्वेन समुचित्य उच्यते सो अधुना सर्वस्य गीताशास्त्रस्य सारभूतः अर्थः द एसेंशियल टीचिंग ऑफ द एंटायर भगवद्गीता विच इज मैंट टू गेन द फाइनल अवर निःश्रेयस टू गेन मोक्ष गीता शास्त्र इज मैंट सो दैट वी अटेन मोक्ष वी अटेन गॉड रियलाइजेशन निःश्रेयस इज कॉल्ड निःश्रेयस सो वॉट इज द मेन Sadhana to gain this nishreyas. What is the anushthana we should do? What is the sadhana we should do? What is the essence of the sadhana which we have to do in order to gain the final goal of our life, nishreyas? That is conveyed in the following words, the last words of this chapter, very beautiful words. So please pay attention and listen to this verse. मत्कर्म कृत मत्परमः मद्भक्तसंगवर्जितः निर्वैरः सर्वभूतेषु यः समामेति पांडव। हे पांडव, दैट वन हु हैज ऑल दिस, वन हु डज ऑल दिस, सच अ पर्सन माम एति एटेन्स मी, कम्स टू मी एटेन्स मी। भगवान हैज सेड दैट ज्ञातुम द्रष्टुम च तत्वेन प्रवेष्टुम च परंतप, यू विल बी एबल टू नो मी, सी मी एंड बिकम वन विथ मी। सो व्हाट इज द साधना, व्हाट इज द वे, हाउ शुड आई गो अबाउट डूइंग इट, व्हाट इज द फुल प्रूफ मेथड ऑफ अटेनिंग यू। भगवान सेज दिस इज इट, आई एम गिविंग यू द एसेंस। ही सेज मत कर्म कृत, द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट डू ऑल योर कर्म फॉर मी। मदर्थम कर्म मत कर्म तत् करोति इति मत कर्म कृत, बिकम अ डूअर ऑफ ऑल कर्म फॉर मी। मीन्स वॉट? वन इज दैट वी डू ऑल अवर ड्यूटीज डेडिकेटिंग इट टू ईश्वर, बट द मेन थिंग इज दैट वी शुड डू ऑल अवर एक्टिविटी विद द इंटेंशन ऑफ अटेनिंग गॉड। वी शुड डू ऑल अवर एक्टिविटी विद द इंटेंशन ऑफ गेनिंग गॉड रियलाइजेशन, ईश्वर अनुभूति। दैट इज कॉल्ड ईश्वर अर्पण कर्म। Means all our karmas are dedicated to Ishvara, means all our karmas are done with the intention of attaining Ishvara alone. Whatever we do, our mind, our agenda should be to attain Ishvara. Means every action which we are performing should take us closer to our goal. That is our purpose, no other purpose, not for any other reason. भगवान को प्राप्त करने के लिए ही सब कर्म करना है। That is called मत कर्म कृत। Not only with that, but keeping that attitude in mind that mat paramaha, that Ishvara alone is my supreme goal, considering Ishvara as param. Here Shankaracharya ji writes ki sometimes a sevak, he does seva of some master, but he doesn't believe or doesn't have the notion that master is my ultimate goal, that after death also I want to become one with my master. No. The worldly boss and all, we don't want to become one with that worldly boss. Similarly, we not only do karma, but about Ishvara, we not only do karma dedicated to Ishvara, but with the intention of becoming one with Ishvara. करोति भृत्य स्वामी कर्म न तु आत्मनः परमा प्रेत्य गंतव्या गति इति स्वामिनं प्रतिपद्यते अयं तु मत कर्म कृत माम एव परमां गतिम। डूइंग कर्म फॉर ईश्वर मीन्स ऑल्सो कीपिंग इन माइंड दैट ईश्वर अलोन इज माय परम गति, माम एव परमां गतिम प्रतिपद्यते इति मत परमः। अहम परमः परा गति ही यस्य स अयम मत परमः। ईश्वर अलोन इज माय परम गति, ईश्वर को ही मुझे प्राप्त करना है। नाइदर एनीथिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड नॉर इंटरेस्टेड इन अटेनिंग सम अदर वर्ल्ड नॉर इंटरेस्टेड टू गेन मोर बर्थ इन दिस वर्ल्ड और अदर वर्ल्ड, बट विद द सोल इंटेंशन of gaining God realization, Ishvara anubhuti. Is pe chintan karo, vichar karo. That should be our intention behind all our karma, ki mujhe Ishvara ko prapta karna hai. then automatically all our karmas will get directed towards Ishvara. See, we have tremendous energy, tremendous power, tremendous potential. What is required is the right intention. You must have heard even stories of tremendous strength coming out of ordinary people. There are stories where the mother comes to know that, oh, the child is there in the in that vehicle, car, and it has caught fire and I have to save. She just rushes there and even lifts that car and brings out that child from that car and saves the child. That extra strength and energy and fearlessness and everything comes when our intention and aim is clear and nothing else is there. Others may hesitate to do any work. Similarly, if our intention is clear that I want Ishvara and Ishvara alone, then all our actions, all our energy will be directed towards Ishvara only. That's called Mat Karma Krit and Mat Paramaha. We have seen in the 9th chapter also, Bhagavan says, even if the person is the worst sinner in this world, but when he decides to attain me, you consider that person as a sadhu. Apichet sudurachara bhajate mam ananya bhak sadhureva samantavya samyak vyavasito hisah. Consider that person because he has resolved well. He has decided properly. Then nothing can stop that person. So, mat karma krit, mat paramaha. Mat bhaktaha and mat bhakta, totally devoted to me. See, all these sadhanas are interconnected. They help each other, they nourish each other. With that total bhakti, when we do our karma and totally dedicate ourselves to Ishvara, we move towards Ishvara alone, towards Ishvara Anubhuti. So, mad bhaktaha, mera bhakta, maam eva sarva prakarai sarvatmana sarva utsahena bhajate iti mad bhaktaha. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji says that in all ways he worships me, and with all enthusiasm, not with boredom and oh, what to do and all, no. With total enthusiasm, in all ways, person is devoted to Ishvara and Ishvara alone. 100%. This is spirituality is not a time pass path. One has to dedicate oneself into this 100%. Not on some festival day or some Sundays or some Mondays or some Ekadashi or something like that or Dasera. It's a continuous dedication. Day and night dedicated to attain Ishvara. Bilkul, one should get possessed of it. One should be possessed. Absolutely. See, even to attain some worldly things in this world, people require so much of dedication. If you want to get some gold in Olympic, if you are a sports person, you want to get gold in the next Olympic, you have to, every day you have to put forth lots and lots and lots of effort practicing and getting ready for that. Hours together. then you have some chance of winning. It's just worldly attainment. In case of attaining Ishvara, we require more than that, total dedication. Bilkul sharanagati, not some just emotional thing. With proper understanding, totally dedicate ourselves to attain Ishvara. So that is madbhaktaha. And what comes in the way of attaining Ishvara, what comes in the way of our sadhana? Our attachments, our holding on to little things of this world, out of attachment. See, even when we know that these are not great things, these are not my ultimate goal, but I get attached. And due to those attachments, I don't do my sadhana with full dedication. Attachment to what? Shankaracharya ji writes, ki dhana, putra, mitra, kalatra, bandhu vargeshu. Sometimes we are attached to our wealth. The wealth which we have, or totally thinking of acquiring more and more wealth. Paise mein hi man hai, laga hua. Or putra, or in our children. Or mitra, or in our friend circle, constantly interacting, chatting and moving and with friends, partying. Or kalatra, husband or wife, all the time attached. Or bandhushu, or relatives. Relatives occupy most of our time. रिलेटिव को ये करना है, वो करना है, उसका काम करना है, उसको मिठाई भेजनी है दिवाली की. सो बंधु वर्गेशु संग विवर्जितः, वी शुड बिकम टोटली डिटैच फ्रॉम ऑल दिस. डिटैच डजंट मीन यू डोंट लव देम. डिटैच डजंट मीन यू डोंट डू योर ड्यूटीज टुवर्ड्स देम. यू डू, बट डोंट गेट involved with them so much that you neglect your sadhana, that you neglect Ishvara. Ishvara is the most important. Baki kuch nahi. See, when a person is sick, though he might be very busy and very lot of work is there and all, like nowadays with this, all this corona, if a person comes to know that he is sick and he has to go to the hospital to get treated, he drops all his work. He doesn't say, no, mera meeting hai important, mujhe wo attend karna hai. I have that other work. I don't have time to go to the hospital and get cured. Nothing doing. He drop everything, whoever that person. He goes to the hospital, gets himself treated. Sometimes he's on the ventilator and all. Kuch nahi. Hum sab chhod ke apne aap ko bachane ke liye sab karte hai. Because my life is most important to me. In the same way, Ishvara should be most important to us, even greater than our own life. That is called total dedication to Ishvara. Nothing comes in between. Jake napriya Rama bhaye dehi tajaya tahi koti bhairi sama jatyapi paramasanehi. Tulsidas ji says that for those who don't have that affection for Sia Ram, even if they are your own relatives and friends, just drop them. don't interact with them, means don't what you call have attachment to them. Because of them, don't drop Ishvara. किसी के लिए भगवान को मत छोड़ो. भगवान के लिए सब कुछ छोड़ सकते हैं, लेकिन किसी के लिए भी भगवान को मत छोड़ो. सो संगवर्जितः निर्वैरस सर्वभूतेषु. अगेन अनदर थिंग इज डोंट हैव हेट्रेड फॉर एनीवन. वैराग्य डजंट मीन वी शुड डिसलाइक पीपल, हेट देम, बिकम इंटॉलरेंट टुवर्ड देम. नहीं, वन शुड हैव दैट लव फॉर ईश्वर हु इज प्रेजेंट इन एवरी वन, बट डोंट बी अटैच टू देयर बॉडी, माइंड, पर्सनैलिटी. बी अटैच टू द ईश्वर हु इज रिसाइडिंग इन द हार्ट ऑफ ऑल बीइंग्स. सो भगवान सेज निर्वैरस सर्वभूतेषु, डोंट हैव एनी वैर towards any beings, because if you have vaira even for one being, you are having vaira for me only, because I am there in that, the heart of that being. So nirvaira sarva bhuteshu, kisi se vair nahi. And nirgata vaira sarva bhuteshu shatru bhava rahitah, without having that shatru bhava, enmity, attitude of enmity towards them. Atmanah atyanta apakara pravrutteshu api, even those who have done lot of harm to you, don't have any feeling of enmity toward them. Keep them away, but don't have any hatred or dislike, or because that will take our mind in them only, and it will take our mind away from Paramatma. सो निर्वैरस सर्वभूतेषु, किसी से वैर नहीं, भगवान को ही प्राप्त करना है. ऐसा अगर हो जाता है तो यस स मामेति पांडव, सच अ पर्सन कम्स टू मी, विल अटेन मी, विल नो मी, विल सी मी एंड विल बी मी. ज्ञातुं द्रष्टुं च तत्त्वेन प्रवेष्टुं च परंतप, विल बी एबल टू नो मी एज आई एम, विल बी एबल टू सी मी इन ऑल माय ग्लोरीज, एंड विल बी एबल टू बिकम वन विथ मी, गेन मोक्ष. सो द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल थिंग भगवान कन्वेड इन दिस वन श्लोक. मत कर्म कृत मत परमः मत भक्त संगवर्जितः निर्वैरस सर्वभूतेषु यस समामेति पांडव. दस कंक्लूड्स दिस ब्यूटिफुल चैप्टर, द 11th चैप्टर, विश्वरूप दर्शन योग. ओम तत्सद इति श्रीमद् भगवद् गीतासु उपनिषत्सु ब्रह्म विद्यायां योगशास्त्रे श्रीकृष्णार्जुन संवादे विश्वरूपदर्शनयोगो नाम एकादशोऽध्यायः. एकादशाध्याय. ओम तत्सत् इज द नेम इंडिकेटर ऑफ दैट सुप्रीम रियलिटी. इन दिस भगवद्गीता विच इज 18 उपनिषद. भगवद्गीता इज लाइक 18 उपनिषद. द ब्रह्म विद्या, द नॉलेज ऑफ ब्रह्म, and the science of yoga is conveyed in this Bhagavad Gita through a dialogue between Krishna and Arjuna. Vishwarupa Darshana Yoga, most fascinating, beautiful chapter. So you please study this chapter again and again, listen to the talks. If you missed, you listen again, or if you have heard, you are listen to it again and again. Share this my videos with your friends and relatives and all other various groups, so that more and more people come to understand this. And practice all that is said here. So more about then we completed this chapter today. So we will begin with the 12th chapter now. 12th chapter is most beautiful. See, every chapter I say is beautiful, but 12th chapter is really very sweet and beautiful and a very short chapter, Bhakti Yoga. So that we will see. We will begin the study of this 12th chapter from Monday. Tomorrow is Saturday and day after Sunday. Day after we have Dasera also. So wish you all a very happy Dasera. And we will begin with this 12th chapter from Monday. Okay. So till then you take care. Be happy, safe, peaceful, healthy. And see, study. Whatever you have learned, you should keep revising and contemplating and studying. Otherwise it gets evaporated. You might be enjoying and understanding also while listening to my pravachan. But take down notes, revise them again and again, so that it becomes your own understanding. Now you are just experiencing and listening to my understanding. But my understanding should become your understanding. Should become your second nature. It should go deep within. Okay, so for that you have to keep revising, keep contemplating on this topic, on the beautiful chapters of Bhagavad Gita. Okay, so more about this, and we will begin with the 12th chapter on Monday. Till then, you take care of yourself, be happy, safe, peaceful, healthy, have a good Navratri celebration. And a very, very happy Dasera to you all. Hari Om. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram. 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 Jaya Jaya Ram. Jaya Jaya Ram. Bole Siyavar Ramachandra Bhagwan ki jay. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.